You've been using Docker for quite a while now, and it looks like it's eating your entire disk space. Don't worry, because in this video, I will show you a couple of simple commands to get an overview on that and clean it all up. Okay, to show you how quickly a disk can fill up when using Docker and when you're not paying attention, I'm going to give a quick demo here, and I'm going to use Play with Docker for that. That's my favorite sandboxing tool, so playwithdocker.com. I'm going to create a new instance, so it's a freshly provided instance with Docker. So when I do Docker version, we'll see that 17.03 is installed. That's great. And since we're talking disk here, what I'm going to do is do a check on my current disk usage. So I've a 10 gigabyte disk for me available, of which almost 500 megs is used, which totals in 9.6 gigabytes of usage. So that's what we are gonna start with. So what I'm gonna do now is create a Docker file. And I'm gonna create a new image, and I'm going to create an image from the Alpine image as a base image. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to write three basically random files that are each 1 gigabyte large, so in total 3 gigabytes. I'm going to use the dd command for that. Input file is just def0, output file I'll call it 1G, 1 for 1 gigabyte, number 1, with the image extension, with a block size of 1 gigabyte. And of course, I just want one of those. So this totals in a file of 1 gigabyte. And now I'm going to run the same. So now here we have three 1 gigabyte files. And as a command, I'll just use bin true. Not going to do anything special with this image. So, closing that up. All right, my Docker file is ready. And now I'm going to build this file and tag it test. Okay, so this file is ready, and this should result in an image of 3 gigabytes large. So by running docker image ls command, I'll see that I have both the Alpine, the base image, and then my test image, which results in a 3 and a bit gigabytes. So also on my disk usage, of course, 6.5 now, so 3 gigabytes less than what I started with, 9.5. This is expected behavior. Now, assume I made a mistake. Instead of three files of 1 gigabyte, I actually wanted 2. So I need to adjust my Docker file for that. I'm gonna open it up again. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove one line. And I'm also gonna add an extra command on top. Basically, what I want to achieve here is remove all the caching while building. So I'm going to echo foo here. My intention is now to only have a file of 2 gigabytes, 2 files of 1 gigabyte. So very naively going to build this. So this file is ready now. Now, very naively, I could assume that when I check my disk space, I would have 1 gigabyte, but that's not true. So now instead of 6.5, I went to 4.5, so even 2 more, obviously, because that old image is still lying around somewhere. So if I check it again with the image ls command, I'll see, of course, my test image, my new one is here, 2 gigabytes. The old one is still lying around, and the Alpine image is there. So yeah. In the end, you start piling up these images and they allocate a lot of disk space. So to kind of give you a good view on your usage within the Docker system, since Docker 1.13, they introduced Docker system command called df, a bit similar to the Linux command that I run. And this command will give you a nice view on everything that's been going on your system. So three images over here, a column over here, reclaimable, that will how much disk space it will clear up. Containers haven't been run, so zero, and volumes, we'll tap into that later. So one thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a Docker run of my test image. Okay, that's done. So yeah, was just the bin through, so nothing really happened as output. But if I do a Docker ps-a, I'll see, okay, my container has been run. Now, when I run the df, the Docker system df again, story is a little bit different, because now I have a running container that is not active anymore. The reclaimable amount is lower, since now we have an image that is tied to a container, so that cannot be cleaned up. Of course, we want to clean everything up, so in that under that same system namespace, there is a prune command. And this gives me a warning, because now here we're going to throw away a lot of stuff. And if we don't pay attention, we throw things away that we actually didn't want it. So what's going to happen in this command, like all the stopped containers will be removed. Also all volumes and networks, but we'll get into that later. And then all dangling images. So all images that have no connection whatsoever anymore are going to be cleaned up. So in our case, the intermediary image that I made with the tree files that isn't used or referred to anywhere anymore, that's going to be cleaned up. So when I say yes to this command, what I see now is that my one stopped container is cleaned up, all dangling images, so also all the intermediary images that have been created while I was building my image, and the total reclaimed space is about 3 gigabytes. So this is allocated from that three gigabyte file image. When I want to clean everything up, I again do a prune command, but I add one parameter, and this is like a deep clean of your Docker system, because when I run this, what you'll see is that you get a warning again with more or less the same output, but there's one very important thing here that's different. It's at the end where it says all images without at least one container associated to them. So when I run this, basically right now, I'm gonna clean up my entire system. And there we go. So no containers cleaned up, but all images that had no container, and since I don't have any containers in my system anymore, all images were cleaned up and 2 gigabytes was reclaimed. So it should be noted that running the prune command isn't without warning. So it's really important to understand what you're doing, and especially with the dash A command. Now in my next demo, I'm gonna show how also volumes obviously have a big impact on your disk space and disk usage. Create a new Play with Docker instance, a second one over here. And I'm gonna use a project that we've used in an earlier demo, namely the WordPress demo, which is cloned from there. I'll link the description down below. So there's a Docker Compose file in there, which I'll very quickly show. So it's a WordPress container in here with a volume, a database container, MySQL with a named volume, DBData, and then a PHP MyAdmin container, one network, and one named volume, as I said earlier. So if I'll docker compose up dash d, okay, everything is pulled in and running right now. So I should be having a WordPress environment running. And the nice thing about Play with Docker is that it shows you all the running exposed ports. So on port 80, I should now have a WordPress installation, stock installation of WordPress. So that's good, that's running. Now gonna stop this environment. All right, that's gone. Docker volume listing. And as you can see, so there's the DB data that I said earlier, and two other volumes that we've been using. Now, let's say I don't care about this project anymore, so I'm gonna delete everything. There we go. So the project is entirely deleted now. Containers are gone. But the thing is that still all the volumes are lying around. Now, in this case, it's a small project, so they don't take much space. But assuming that you have bigger databases, if they keep lying around, there's a lot of overhead. Especially since, let's say, from the same folder again, I rerun my project over here. Since the DB data was a named volume, it's going to reuse that one. But all the non-named volumes, the anonymous volumes, are going to keep piling up every time I remove and restart this project. So again, Docker system df. And what this is telling me is that there's three images, WordPress, PHP MyAdmin, and MySQL. And I also have three local volumes. So my named one and then the two old ones from the first run of this project. Nothing's running anymore. There's no containers anymore. So when I do a system prune, so when I say yes to that, all the volumes were cleaned up. My network was cleaned up and it reclaimed 226 megabytes. But let's assume now I want to clean up, do a deep clean. So I add a dash A. Now all the images without a container will be removed. Doing that. There we go. All the intermediary images, everything was removed and I got almost 1 gigabyte reclaimed. In this demo, I tried to show you that using Docker day in and day out might be piling up images, containers, volumes on your system, all taking disk space. But I also showed you that Docker now has a couple of very simple commands to clean up your system and get an overview of what's going on. So if you enjoyed this, please leave a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel to get updates on next videos.